we have some more participants yet to join. Actually, there is a neck to neck two sessions going on. One session just
okay
will be completed in another few minutes for us only. So that is the reason some of us are there. I just left the meeting in between. So, like that got a little extended. I think that's the reason. But few people will join. So, so that's the reason I'm also doing this. Yeah.
If all are okay, we can start. I mean, people let the people join as and when they come.
Yeah. People are joining. So, yes. So, friends, we have with us today Mr. Raj Lakhotia. He is a chartered accountant by profession, and our volatility coach Ajay Bhil, and Raj, our business partners as far as mutual funds are concerned. So he is amongst us only, not somebody who is from outside or maybe from a different industry or a different vendor. So I will not say that. So and we also share another platform of Pranic Healing, where we do spiritual practice. And today, the specialization is in a subject called will. I think as a financial advisor, we all are actually looking forward to help our clients in some or other way so that we can advise them as far as wills are concerned. So will is something which is very, very important and something which is very, very crucial as far as advisors are concerned. So today's topic is all about understanding will, how we can actually deal with will. And also I have requested Raj to elaborate a little bit on, a lot of clients when they have wills, they can think that they have a will, but how complicated that can be or how simple that can be and how actually people can have a little trouble as far as no cases and all are concerned. I'm sure everything, whatever will come to you will be in a very, very simple format to understand. And he's also going to share a lot of things, a lot of insights. So all the best to everyone. And special thanks to Raj for taking out time and coming and sharing all his learnings of years with us. Thank you, Raj. Thank you and welcome, and over to you now. You can share the screen also. I have made you the co-host if there is something.
Thank you, Pranav, for the warm introduction and also organizing this program, giving me this opportunity to come and share my understanding on this subject, which is highly unconventional. And thanks to all the attendees to take out time and to attend this program. When I said it is highly unconventional, will is one subject which is very less talked about, especially in India. If we see, neither in our school curriculum nor in our professional curriculum or otherwise, there is any forum on which we have been taught about succession planning, life after death, will, how to pass on the legacy, and so on and so forth. This subject assumes greater significance in present scenario when everyone is very, right now very, lot of anxiety is there in the system and uncertainties, fear prevailing in the system, as in what is going to happen in the time to come. More specifically, one of the challenge which I see people face for not having succession planning in place is not having time. So in present scenario, we have enough time also to think about our succession plan and also to make the plan in place. Let me share my screen with all of you so that you can have the presentation with us. Just a second. Is it visible?
Yes.
Okay. So recently there was a big strife over inheritance of wealth between a father and son in the corporate world. I'm sure since all of you are from the investment consultancy background, you must have heard about Singhania versus Singhania. Mr. Vijaypat Singhania, who was the founder of Raymond's, has gifted his entire stakes in Remons to his son Gautam Singhania in 2015. And this was his comment to the NDTV. In the 79 years of my life, I did never thought I would have to take a family dispute to court after giving away everything I had, and that even I do not have a roof over my head. Since Nirupa Roy, everyone knows about her, she's Ma of Bollywood. She had a property in Malabar Hill, and recently there was a big fight between her two brothers, two sons, over her property, and police need to intervene. She is Aretha Franklin. She was known as Queen of Soul. She has won 18 Grammy Awards. She has sang at the inauguration of Barack Obama, Bill Clinton, and people like that. She died in August 2018 with a net worth of $80 million and many musical rights in her favor. Her estate was divided equally among her four children, according to the law of Michigan. But TMZ has reported that she had a specially abled son which had specific requirement and financial needs, and someone has to take care of those specific requirement and needs because that son was differently abled. But since she did not have made any will, now the future of that son is uncertain. These are few cases which are reported. We get to hear and we get to know about this type of cases day in, day out. Some are reported, some are not reported, and some are settled out of court. As per the PIB data, there are 3 crore cases which are pending before various courts in India. Out of them, 76% belongs to the property and the family dispute. If we look at the world, United States, people are highly proactive about their succession plan, about the passing on of the legacy, and they are very much active about creating trust and making will. However, if you look at UK, the number of inheritance disputes reaching the High Court each year has soared to a record high. This was a report from a local law firm. China, world's most populous nation, has the second largest economy, one of the highest saving rates, mushrooming wealth, yet virtually no will, and it's going to be a big problem for China nowadays. Now, if we look at India, still in India, people are hesitant about talking about life after death. They do not talk about how to distribute and when to distribute their property amongst their family members. हस्बैंड को लगता है वाइफ से बात करेंगे तो वाइफ दो दिन तीन दिन तक रोने रोने बैठ जाएगी कि आप मरने की बात क्यों कर रहे हैं. फादर को लगता है कि बेटा यदि विल से रिलेटेड बात कर रहा है तो उसको उसकी प्रॉपर्टी में इंटरेस्ट है. बेटे को लगता है कि मेरी उम्र अभी बहुत कम है, व्हाई डू आई नीड टू थिंक अबाउट विल एट दिस स्टेज ऑफ माई लाइफ. रीजन इज हार्डली देयर इज एनी अवेयरनेस अबाउट what is the importance of the will and succession planning, and what could go wrong if the will and succession planning is not in place. You all are financial advisor, you interact with a lot of businessmen during your daily routine. You have seen people made a lot of effort to earn money. They made their annual plan, their 5 years plan, their 10-year plan, and then at the same time, they make sure that all their plans are come through, and they put full effort so that they achieve their target. And the money that they earn out of that, they come to you to invest that money into various assets class so that they can grow their money. Now, but I fail to understand that they do not have the objective in place, as in what are they going to do with the ultimate wealth that they are going to create. What is their objective? What will they do with this wealth after their death? There could be two scenarios. They have various milestones in their life, various goals they need to achieve, and based on that goals and the milestones that they have to reach, you make their succession plan. One scenario could be that the person has achieved all their milestones and all the goals are achieved. बेटे की शादी हो गई, हायर स्टडीज हो गई, बेटी की शादी हो गई, घर ले लिया, सब कुछ कर लिया. नाउ जो वेल्थ बचा है उस वेल्थ का अब हम क्या करें? देयर इज नो ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड दे डोंट वांट टू थिंक अबाउट इट. रीजन अवेयरनेस नहीं है. सेकेंड सिनेरियो ये भी हो सकता है कि गोल अचीव नहीं हुए हैं सारे अभी, इन बिटवीन द पर्सन हैज डाइड. नाउ व्हाट टू डू सो दैट ऑल द गोल्स व्हिच हैज बीन सेट कैन अचीव इन अ प्रॉपर मैनर. With these few thoughts, let me get into the subject. What is a will? Friends, will is a legal document. It is a declaration by which shows the intention of the testator. Testator is the person who writes the will. It shows it's his intention, how he wants to distribute or dispose or pass on his assets to his relatives or for that matter to anybody else after his death. So if you look into the various characteristics, it's a legal declaration. It is about his property. Mind you that one can bequeath his own property only. The property which doesn't belong to him, in which he is not a legal owner, he cannot bequeath that. And will manifest only after the death of the person. And the person can revoke his will, review his will any number of times during his lifetime. Now the question comes, who can make the will? Any person who is mature and is of sound mind can make the will. That means any person who is illiterate or an old person or a terminally ill person can also make the will, obviously with certain safety clause, so that if the will gets challenged, विल को एग्जीक्यूट होने में दिक्कत नहीं आए. इंटॉक्सिकेटेड पर्सन कैन ही मेक द विल? द लॉ सेज दैट इफ अ पर्सन डू नॉट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट ही इज डूइंग देन ही कैन नॉट मेक द विल. द अंडरलाइन प्रिंसिपल इज दैट द पर्सन शुड बी अवेयर ऑफ व्हाट ही इज डूइंग एंड देन ओनली द विल इज कंसिडर्ड एज अ वैलिड विल, अदरवाइज इट कैन बी इनवैलिडेटेड बाय द कोर्ट. What about a deaf, a dumb, or a blind person? Again, the same principle applies that if they know, then obviously they can make their will. I'm sure everyone here has seen the movie Ghazni. In movie Ghazni, Aamir Khan ko short-term memory loss ho jati thi, beech-beech mein. And because of that, wo bhul jata tha ki usne kya kiya hai. So in such scenario, can that person make a will? The law says that an insane person cannot make a will. However, during the interval when he attains his sanity, he can make his will. Now the question comes is, just a second, a screen pe kuch problem hai. Sorry. So now the question is, what if the will is not in place? How the property gets transferred to the next generation? How the people distribute the property? So in case if the succession plan or the will is not in place, that state is called the intestate succession, which means that the succession law of the land will be prevailing and the succession law will guide how to distribute the assets of the person. And in India, the succession law is based on the religion of the person. If the person is Hindu or Jain or Sikh, it is Hindu Succession Act. If the person is Christian, Parsi and Jew, it is Indian Succession Act. And in case of Muslim, it is Muslim law. Now let's get into understanding about how the property of a male Hindu is distributed as per the succession law. So succession law mein relatives ko char classes mein baanta gaya hai. Class 1 legal heir, class 2 legal heir, class 3 and class 4 legal heir. So in case of male Hindu who dies without having will or intestate, then the first class which is looked into is the class 1 legal heir. In class 1 legal heir there are four relatives: mother, widow, son and daughter. इन चार तरह के रिलेटिव्स में से जितने भी जन है उनको पूरी प्रॉपर्टी इक्वली डिस्ट्रीब्यूट हो जाती है. सो इफ सपोज इफ अ पर्सन हैज मदर विडो वन सन एंड वन डॉटर देन द होल प्रॉपर्टी विल बी डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड इन इक्वल रेशियो दैट इज 25% ईच. नाउ इफ सपोज द सन इज प्री डिसीज्ड देन इन दैट केस सन के जो लीगल हेयर्स हैं उनको सन का शेयर मिल जाता है. But if there is no one available in class 1, then the law says that you move to class 2 legal heir. Now in class 2 legal heir, the rule of succession is that those in the first entry in class 2 shall prefer to those in the second entry. And ek entry mein jitne bhi relatives hain unko equal distribution hota hai. That means what? Class 2 mein there are 6-7 entries which are given chronological order mein. सबसे फर्स्ट एंट्री में यदि कोई रिलेटिव अवेलेबल है तो उस एंट्री में जितने भी रिलेटिव्स हैं उनको इक्वली डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन हो जाएगा. नाउ क्लास थ्री लीगल हेयर्स आर कॉल्ड एग्नेट्स. एग्नेट्स आर पीपल हु आर रिलेटेड बाय ब्लड ओनली थ्रू मेल्स, दैट इज फादर ब्रदर के डॉटर वगैरह. एंड इफ क्लास थ्री इज नॉट अवेलेबल देन वी मूव टू द क्लास फोर लीगल हेयर्स दैट इज को एग्नेट्स. एंड इन केस ऑफ को एग्नेट्स इट इज रिलेटेड through female. This is how the distribution happens in case of male Hindu. Let's take an illustration to understand it in a proper manner. A Hindu male died intestate. Legal heirs left are mother, father, wife, son, daughter-in-law, daughter, son-in-law. In this case, class one legal heir is mother, wife, son and daughter. They will get 25% each. Ironically, you will find that father is not into the class 1 legal heir. Father is into the class 2. So here the father is not going to get anything. Now, this is a very absurd scenario and it has been asked to ministry at various level and various times that why father has been put into the class 2? Why not in class 1? And aap sochiye ki yadi किसी बंदे का फादर डिपेंडेंट है और मदर नहीं है उसके और उस बंदे को कुछ हो जाता है तो फादर के पास में कुछ नहीं जाना है. इट इज गोइंग टू बी अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट सिनेरियो, मोर स्पेसिफिकली फादर इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन दिस पर्सन. इन द केस टू द लीगल हेयर आर वाइफ, ब्रदर, सिस्टर, सन्स विडो, हिज डॉटर्स. Now in this case, wife, son's widow and predeceased daughter being the class 1 legal heir, they are going to get 33.33% each. However, siblings, that is brother and sister, they will not get anything because they are the class 2 legal heir. What happens in case of female Hindu? Now female Hindu ke case mein, the law says that the absolute property of the Hindu female, she can deal with the same in any manner she wants. So what is the absolute property of the Hindu female? The absolute property of the Hindu female is what she gets out of the inheritance. Apne baap dada se ya kahin se bhi unko inheritance mein kuch mila hai. Out of the partition, she is a co-partner in her father's HUF. The father's HUF is partitioned and she has some property out of that. She has got some property in lieu of maintenance, maybe because of divorce or some other issues. She has got some gifts. She has earned some money out of her own skill or own business, and she has purchased some property. These all are considered as the absolute property of the Hindu female. Now, in case of Hindu female, the succession order is first it goes to the son and husband. If son, daughter, and husband, any of them are available, it goes to them. If none of them are available, then it goes to the legal heir of the husband. Now, legal heir of the husband is the legal heir defined in class 1, class 2 legal heirs in case of male. Now, if legal heirs of husband are also not available, then property reverts back to the parents of the lady. If parents of lady are not alive, then it goes to the legal heirs of the father. Or otherwise, it goes to the legal heir of the mother. Now, some exception to this rule. The exception is that at the time of death of the lady, if she doesn't have any children, then in that case, if the property has been inherited from her father, then it reverts back to the
It seems there is a Raj has got disconnected. So let me just have a check again. Yes, Ajay, you are there. Ajay, are you with Raj? Because it seems it's not. Hello, Ajay, you are there now. Ajay, it seems Raj is disconnected.
राज कहा सिमरन के यहाँ पे गया क्या?
राज, we'll have to check. Anyway, it's an interesting topic and an interesting session, and I think very very useful. And Raj is doing.
तब तक connect कर दिया जाए तब हमें कुछ बात करना चाहता हूँ on the same topic, will planning पे. Okay, okay. I just completed a chartered trust estate planner. Okay, six months back, and now we have started a practice of and all clients ke liye will planning write karna.
Okay, now Raj is there back.
Yes, sab logon ne karna chahiye. It's a good.
So welcome, Raj. I think you got a little disconnected. So just a second, we'll. Making you co-host again.
At which stage I disconnected, can you tell me so that I can start from there?
The previous slide, I think, if you.
This one? Female Hindu?
Yeah, this is only, yes.
Yeah.
This was, I think, this was going on in between you stop.
Okay. So basically, the succession order in case of female Hindu, is that clear? Can I move ahead with that, or should I restart with the succession order?
Exceptions you can just share.
Okay. So the succession order is, first it is to son, daughter and husband. If son, daughter and husband are not available, then in that case the legal heir of husband. If none of the legal heirs are alive, then parents. If not, parents are not alive, then in that case, the legal heir of father, or otherwise the legal heir of mother. These are the succession order in case of female Hindu. However, there are certain exceptions that at the time of death of the lady, if the lady do not have any children alive, or children, if the lady do not have any children also, then in such case, if the property which has been inherited from the parents of the lady, it will revert back to the father's legal heir. And if the property is inherited from the husband or the father-in-law, then it reverts back to the husband's legal heir. Same, we can take one illustration for that as well. A Hindu female dies intestate, leaves behind her husband, two sons and parents. In this case, husband and two sons will get 1/3 share each. However, parents won't get anything because the husband and sons are alive. Similarly, in case two, Hindu female inherits a house from father, dies intestate without any child, leaving behind husband, father's brother, father's sister, and husband's sister. Now, in this case, since the lady do not have any children, And at the same time, the lady has inherited the house from the father. The property will revert back to the father's legal heir, that is father's brother and father's sister. And nobody else will get anything out of this. This is how the succession law in India prevailed in case of Hindu male and female. And that is where the importance of will is come into the picture. It helps you to avoid any dispute amongst the family members of the deceased. Otherwise, there will be a lot of dispute that who is going to get what, how much, and in what ratio. It also helps you to distribute the assets as per your own wish. We have 4 or 5 family members. Not necessarily everyone has the equal requirement. And you being the head of the family, you want to give people as per their requirements. So that is possible only through the succession planning or through the will only. Otherwise, it will be distributed equally to all. It will also help and support to the near and dear one. As I said that in case the succession law comes into the picture, the near relatives only going to get anything out of the property. But at times, some log hamari family mein dekhte hain ki there are some family members who are not falling under class 1 or class 2, but we have some moral responsibilities towards them because they are our extended family members. Or for that sake, some of your friend has helped you during your tough time, and today he is looking up to you, so that you feel that it is your moral duty to support him in case you want to give something, in case you want to give something out of your property. And unless you have will in place, you cannot give, because succession law doesn't recognize that person as a successor. It also helps you to fulfill your financial and philanthropic goals. Again, succession law gives the property only to the near and dear relatives in your family. Now, if you have any philanthropic goals, you want some money to be given for charity purpose, for the benefit of the society, that is not possible as per the succession law. You can give it only through if you have will in place. Also, to help the family to maintain the life even if you are not available. If suppose the will is not in place and there are a lot of disputes going on in the family so far as distribution of the property is concerned, immediate maintenance of family is a big question. That will help you to avoid that. So these are the possible issues that arises in absence of will. The reconciliation of dispute in the family is a big question. Testator wishes are not fulfilled. आपकी इच्छा थी कि आप एक्स को इतना रुपया देंगे, वाई को इतना रुपया देंगे, जेड को इतना रुपया देंगे, whereas as per law सबको इक्वली डिस्ट्रीब्यूट हो गया. Maintenance of family may be affected. Also, as per the reports, the statistics suggest that if a family dispute goes to court, it takes at least 10 to 15 years of time to sort out the matter, and the cost of litigation is very high. Now imagine a situation that your hard-earned money, which you have earned for your family with the intention that your family's sustainability cannot be, you know, questioned at any point of time. But because this simple document is not in place, the property goes to the dispute, and the money is earned by the lawyers only. Again, process of transfer of assets become very lengthy and cumbersome if the will document is not in place. You need to get the succession certificates done. Again, even if you get the succession certificate, the distribution will be done only as per the law. With this, friends, let's get more understanding about will. What is a will? How it is made? What is the format of the will? What are the key features? The will ka koi fixed format nahi hai. There is no fixed format of the will. You can write will in any manner you want. What we advise is to, in order to avoid any dispute at a later stage, it should be properly and legally correct also. However, just to share with you that the smallest will in the world is 3-word will, that is all to some. It is so simple. It can be handwritten, it can be on a plain paper, and registration is not compulsory. You can not just tangible but intangible assets also you can bequeath through will. Now, in present scenario, a lot of our communication happens through our name. Lot of intangible assets we keep on creating on a daily basis. We have property, copyrights, we have lot of our business plans in our digital assets. We can also transfer those assets through will. The person who writes the will is called testator. Is in case of female, it is called testatrix. He should be a major and that person of sound mind. Beneficiary is typically a person who gets any distribution from the will. He need not be a relative. He can be any person to whom the person wants to give any money. Minor and beneficiaries with special needs, we suggest that you should consider making trust, as because the minor and people with special needs may not be capable of entering into a contract, at the same time may not be able to maintain the property and the assets. So it is a good medium to create trust and transfer the property for their benefits. Again, like beneficiaries, there are non-beneficiaries also which may exist within your family. Maybe you have some dispute with one of the family member, you do not want to give anything to them. Maybe that person is sufficiently well earned and well capitalized, and you do not foresee any reason to give him any assistance. Rather, you want other family members to get more money. So in that case, you can also define the non-beneficiary in your will and exclude a specific person from the will. You can give the reasons behind why do you want to exclude this person. Rather, this is a very important thing to do, because being a legal heir, he can always claim that I have the interest into the property of the deceased person. But if the will document itself reveals that the person has been designated as non-beneficiary because of such and such reason, the chances of getting probate of will becomes very high. Executor is the person who has been entrusted with the task of execution of the will after the death of the person. Basically, he has to approach the court and he has to get the probate done, and then he has to make sure that all the assets are transferred as per the requirement of the as per the provisions of the will. Now, you can have single person as an executor, you can have joint executors, you can have multiple executor, you can have alternate executor. Rather, it is always advisable to have either joint, multiple or the alternate executor, because yadi aap single executor appoint karte hain will mein, to aur jab aapki will ka execution ho raha hai us samay mein yadi executor already deceased hai, to us case mein the court has to appoint somebody else, maybe some professional outside as an executor. So what we advise is you should have a person who is younger than you to be an executor of the will. Witness, friends, witness assume greater significance in case will gets challenged. What happens is witness has to certify that this will is signed in presence of the witness. Now, I'm again emphasizing on this word that witness certify that this document is signed in their presence. They may or may not have the awareness about the content of the document. Rather, they should not get to know about the content of the document. They just certified that the person has signed in their presence and they have signed in presence of the person. In case of dispute, they have been always called by the court to certify that this document was executed in their presence. The witness should always be an independent person, and in order to have a valid will, you need to have at least two witnesses. Probate is to get the authenticity and the finality of will. What happens after the death of the person, you need to submit the will document to the court and get the apply for the authenticity and the finality of the will document. This process is called probating. Probate is compulsory in case of Mumbai, Madras and Kolkata. However, in other areas, it is not compulsory, but still probate is advisable, because once the probate is granted, then that cannot be changed at a later stage at any point of time. The other medium to, for the succession planning is through trust. you know, at times what happens is that the person do not want to hand over the control of the property to the person through will. When you transfer the assets get transferred in the name of the beneficiary. But however, in case of trust, you can define the rules. Ki trust ke rules ye honge, who all will be the trustees, what will be the utilization of the income of the trust, what will be the utilization of the income of the property which has been put into the trust, how will the trust operate, when will the trust dissolve. Everything you can define at this stage itself and will be executed once the will is executed. You can appoint trust right now, or you can appoint trust at the time of execution of will. It is a very useful medium, especially in cases where the stakes are very high, where there are beneficiaries who are minor, who are mentally incapacitated, or in case where the testator feels that he do not want to lose control. At the same time, he wants that the family members should enjoy the benefit of the properties. Now, whether we should make a will or we should have a trust structure depends on many factors. Some of the factors which I have jotted down here is to decide whether we should make a will or we should make the trust are, like in case of will, it takes effect only after the death of the person. However, in case of trust, you can create trust today itself, or you can create trust under your will so that the trust will come into the picture once the will is executed. Probate, chances of dispute and litigation interest in case of trust is very less. However, in case of will also, the dispute and litigations can arise. The control after death, in case of will, you do not have any control once the assets gets transferred. You cannot have any control on the assets. However, in case of trust, you have full control on the assets because the assets are not getting transferred. It is in a joint kitty. Will is not possible during the lifetime of the person. However, trust is possible. State duty saver is possible through trust. In India, state duty is not applicable. However, in advanced countries like UK, US, there are state duties laws. And to save the state duty, people try to use the mode of trust. Wealth planning for minor beneficiaries. Husband, wife, dono ki by chance death ho jati hai, aur bachcha yadi minor hai. So how will he take care of the property, and who will take care of this son or the daughter who is alive, who is minor? If we create a trust structure, then obviously you can define the trustees, you can define the natural guardians for the children, and at the same time you can set the rules as in how the property is going to be utilized, how the income of the property is going to be utilized for the benefit of the minor, and when the trust will dissolve, either at the time of attending the majority of the minor or at the time or at any other point of time which you find is suitable for them. In case of will, to a certain extent it is possible, but largely it is uncontrolled. Friends, during my interaction with people on this subject matter, I have got to understand that people have a lot of confusion about will, misconception about will, and a lot of myths about will. The first one is will need to be registered, will need to be on a stamp paper. There is no such requirement as per law. Registration of will is recommendatory, it is not mandatory. What we suggest is if you foresee that anyone can challenge the will, there are chances of dispute in the will, then we suggest that you get your will registered, because in that case, there is a third party involved, registrar of assurance, who also confirms that this will has been signed and executed in my presence. Otherwise, registration is just a formality. It is not going to help you out. It is just a cost to you. Stamp paper, there is no requirement as per the stamp law. You can make your will on a simple plain paper itself. I have appointed nominee. It is a very interesting question. Everywhere I get to hear about this, that in my bank account I have appointed nominee, in my FDs I have given nominee, in my all the assets I have mentioned nominee, then why do I need to make the will? Let me tell you very honestly, nomination doesn't help you in any manner. Nominee is just a caretaker. Nominee is just a caretaker. It's a temporary stopgap arrangement. He will just help you in liquidating the property, in liquidating the assets. But the nominee is may or may not be the legal owner of the property. The legal owner will always be, in absence of will, the legal heirs as defined in the succession law. Once the legal heirs are established by the court, the succession certificate are issued, the nominee has to transfer the money to the legal heirs. He cannot use that money for any purpose other than that. Joint holders, बहुत सारे बैंक अकाउंट में हम लोग ज्वाइंट होल्डिंग करते हैं. बहुत सारे प्रॉपर्टीज में वी डू वी हैव ज्वाइंट होल्डर्स. समटाइम्स इट इज अ ज्वाइंटली ज्वाइंटली बॉट प्रॉपर्टी ऑल्सो एंड समटाइम्स इट इज जस्ट फॉर द नेम से. सो इन दैट केस वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड इफ इट इज अ ज्वाइंटली ओन्ड प्रॉपर्टी देन ऑब्वियसली यू कैन पार्ट ऑफ योर शेयर इन दैट प्रॉपर्टी थ्रू विल. हाउएवर इफ इट इज जस्ट फॉर नेम से देन द लीगल ओनर इज द पर्सन हु हैज पेड मनी फॉर द property and the other person doesn't have any right in that property. Again, the ownership will remain with the beneficiary and will prevail. The succession law will prevail. The person has to pass on the property to the legal heirs. It is too early to make will. This is the biggest myth I'll say, and people keep on saying that विल 60 साल के बाद देखना चाहिए, 65 साल के बाद में हमें सोचना चाहिए. फ्रेंड्स, टू माई अंडरस्टैंडिंग द एज एट विच वी आर इन, वी शुड सीरियसली कंसिडर मेकिंग आवर विल. आई एम गिविंग यू द लॉजिकल रीजन बिहाइंड दैट. एट द एज ऑफ 60-65 बंदे के जो बच्चे होते हैं वो खुद भी अर्निंग मेंबर बन जाते हैं. 30-40 साल के हो जाते हैं. दे आर doing well in their family. They have their own family. They have their own earnings. The property that they get from their father is add-on to them. However, person of our age, between the age bracket of 35 to 45, हमारे बच्चे minor है. कल को हमें कुछ होता है तो हमारे elders जो कि हमारे ऊपर dependent है, हमारे बच्चे जो कि हमारे ऊपर dependent है, वो सारे के सारे stuck हो जाते हैं यदि हमारी property dispute में चली जाती है. So what we suggest is, as soon as you have some property and you have dependents on you, you should seriously consider making your succession document. At the same time, you don't know when the expiry date is. So it is a strong advice to all the young citizens here that to seriously consider about making your will. What if I change my mind? You can revisit your will any number of times. There is no bar as per law. You can remake your will n number of times. If there are minor changes, you can make codicil. Codicil is the what I'll say, it's a sort of addendum to the main will. When there are minor changes, there is no need to make a revised will. You can make a codicil. And if there are major changes, you can make a revised will. The latest will prevail over the earlier will. It supersedes all the existing will. Now, एक query यहाँ पे ये भी आती है कि यदि किसी ने अपनी अपनी earlier will को register करा रखा है और मैं फिर एक नई will बनाता हूँ तो कौन सी will prevail करेगी? Again, law is very clear. The latest will prevail and supersede above all existing wills, no matter whether it is registered or unregistered. What we advise that in a 3 years of time frame, you should reconsider making your will, revising your will. Reason being, 3 years ke time frame mein aapki assets, aapke properties, aapke thought process, at the same time aapke relationship mein bhi bahut sare changes aate hain. So it is always advisable to revisit your will. Why will? I can gift. Bahut jan bolte hain ki yaar apne family member ko to dena hai. तो विल बनाना, इतने माथा बची करना क्या जरूरत है, हम एक गिफ्ट ही कर देते हैं. नाउ रिमेंबर द केस ऑफ विजयपत सिंघानिया. ही हैज डन द सेम थिंग एंड टुडे इज सफरिंग लाइक एनीथिंग. फ्रेंड्स, इन केस ऑफ गिफ्ट यू रिलिंक्विश योर राइट इन प्रॉपर्टी इमीडिएटली एंड गिफ्ट इज generally irrevocable. You cannot revoke it. There are stamp duty and tax implications also attached with the gift. However, if you make will and pass on the assets through will, then till your lifetime, you will enjoy the property. Subsequent to your death, the property will get transferred to your relatives. You will save the stamp duty also, and any property which is transferred through testamentary document, there is no tax implication of that. Cross-border inheritances, FEMA law, succession and legacy transfer ko recognize karta hai through FEMA, as per FEMA law. Any resident can inherit the foreign currency, foreign security, any foreign immovable property from a person resident outside India. Vis-a-vis, a non-resident can also inherit an Indian currency, Indian security, Indian immovable property from a person resident in India. As most of you here are into the financial planning, let's take one example. In case of Mr. A, he is around 42 years of age with a net worth of 4 crore. He has left 5 family members behind: wife, son. Son A is 16 years, daughter is 13 years, dependent handicapped sister is 40 years, and mother is 65 years. Now, since he has not considered making will, and the distribution has taken place as per law. हमने succession planning उनकी कर रखी थी. Son को higher study के लिए 75 लाख रुपए चाहिए था. Daughter को की marriage और higher study के लिए आपने जमा कर रखा था 1 करोड़ 25 लाख रुपया. Wife की wife को family maintenance के लिए 1 करोड़ रुपए चाहिए थे. Dependent sister के maintenance के लिए 50 लाख चाहिए थे. Mother के लिए 50 लाख चाहिए थे. अब एक simple document नहीं होने के कारण distribution हुआ 4 जन को equal. Now you can see that there are few people who are not going to get anything. There are few who has shortage. There are few who has excess of fund. Yahi point hai jahan pe dispute sare arise hote hai. Jisko kam mila hai ya jisko nahi mila hai, usko lagta hai ki he has been deprived of, and jisko jyada mila usko lagta hai ki why do I share? And that is where all the peace in the family gets distorted, gets hampered. There are a few tips which you can advise your clients, and rather you can also use for your if you consider making your will in order to avoid dispute. You can keep will at a safe place. You can share with your family members that you have considered making your will. However, please don't share the content of your will. That should be kept at utmost secrecy. The place of storage you can share with the executor also. Otherwise, executor will not be able to find out the will document at the time when it is required to be executed. You must sign the will in presence of witness. Generally, क्या होता है? लोग एक जगह sign करते हैं, sign करके document witness के यहाँ भेज देते हैं और बोलते हैं कि तुम sign करके भेज देना. That is not the right approach in case of will document. The will document has to be signed in presence of the witness, and witness also is to be signed in presence of the testator. They both should sign simultaneously at same point of time. You should also consider attaching the doctor's certificate about your physical and mental fitness. You should also mention in the will specifically. I'll share one will document. I'll show one draft will also. You should consider mentioning in your will that it supersedes all your existing will. आपने पहले कभी भी कोई will बना रखी है तो उस will की date को उसमें mention कर दीजिए कि इस date में मैंने will बनाई है और ये सारी will को present will supersede करती है. And court nowadays has recognized video recording of will also. If you are the will signing ceremony, you can video record and kept as an evidence so that the chances of dispute will be less. Let me share with you the one draft will copy. So this is the will draft. You see, in the first para, what we mention is about who is writing the will. What is his details, personal detail, what is his religion, he has born on which state, what is his occupation, his post office, police station, district, whatever. The second para, which is very important, which mentions that I hereby cancel and revoke all my previous wills testamentary deposition codicil, if any, made earlier and declared this is to be my last will. This will shall be effective after my death. This is a very important line, which is considered by the court as and when they issue the probate. Then there are certain personal details about your life. How old are you? How was your life? Who did you marry to? Who all are your children? You should give a brief background about your life so that one can correlate. Will should be a speaking document, as if the person is standing in front and speaking about what he wants to do about his property and why he wants to do about his property, distribute his property. So it should be a speaking document wherein you should properly mention everything about your life, the major things relating to the distribution of the assets. Then you should give the details of the beneficiaries, who all are the beneficiaries, jisko ki aap assets dena chahte hain, unse aapka kya relation hai, kya naam hai unka, kya relation hai. And then you list out all your properties. This is the section where you can list out all your properties, your immovable properties, your movable properties, bank account, fixed deposit, shares, mutual fund, PMS, or any sort of deposit or assets that you have. And then this is the clause which is very important. This is residuary properties. At times it happens that बंदे ने आज बिल बनाई है और चार साल बाद में बिल एग्जीक्यूट हो रही है. ड्यूरिंग दिस फोर ईयर उसने अपने बिल को रिविजिट नहीं किया, रिव्यू नहीं किया. इस चार साल में जो प्रॉपर्टी नहीं बन गई उसका क्या हुआ? सो यू कैन मेंशन इन योर प्रेजेंट बिल दैट एनी प्रॉपर्टी जो कि यहाँ पे स्पेसिफिकली बिक्विट नहीं की गई है, जो कि इंटेस्टेड सक्सेसन में जा सकती है, शुड ऑल्सो बी बिक्विटेड इन द फॉलोइंग मैनर. यू कैन give the details, किसके पास जाएगी और कैसे जाएगी. Beneficiary for residuary and future properties, sharing such assets. Contingent beneficiary, again, at times, you have defined 2, 3, 4 beneficiaries in your will, that property X should go to A, property Y should go to B, and like that. But at the time when the will is getting executed, Mr. A is already deceased. Now what will happen with this property? In absence of any specific condition to that, the property will go to intestate successor and then it will be distributed to the legal heir. However, you can appoint a contingent beneficiary in that case. If Mr. A is not available, then the property which has been bequeathed to Mr. A will go to Mr. X. So this is the contingent beneficiary details which you can give, list of properties, who was the primary beneficiary, who can be the contingent beneficiary if primary beneficiary is not available. Then you should mention about the executor, who is going to be the person who is going to be execute this, obtain the probate, what's the name of the person, what's the address and the contact details of the executor, special wish and instructions. Friends, you can mention your special wish about your last rights, about your whatever conditions you want to put into, any special instructions you want to give relating to your assets, which is legally tenable, you can mention here. You can also bequeath your organs through your will. You can donate your organs through your will. You can mention in your will that this organ should be donated and should not be, should be given to this particular institute or something like that. And there are certain legal paragraphs which are important in order to in order to make sure that in case the will gets challenged, so will ki legality pe koi issue nahi hai. There are multiple formats. If you go to Google, you will find n number of formats of will. Still, I suggest that if you think of making will for yourself or for any of your client, do consider the advice of a person who is expert in the subject. Reason being, एक simple line, आपके will की finality को, आपके will की authenticity को पूरा cancel कर सकता है. So don't go for the format. Go for your idea about what do you want to do with your assets, and ask the proper person to draft it. There is no straightforward draft for this. Then the last thing is, as I mentioned, that the witness and testator should sign in presence of each other. This is a very important para in the will which you should mention, that it is signed by the aforesaid testator in our presence. This is what the witness is saying. This is the witness area and this is the testator area. Signed by the aforesaid testator in our presence, and we have signed this will as attesting witness in the presence of testator and in the presence of each other, all being present at the same time. Court कैसे जानेगा कि ये will किसी बंदे ने sign किया है, testator ने ही sign किया है, या witness ने ही ये will, ये document sign किया है? This is the para which gives this authenticity कि ये तीनों चीजें एक साथ simultaneously एक ही समय पे हुई है. This is a simple format of will based on the various conditions which we put in the will. We can draft according to the requirement of the person. So these are the provisions, various provisions which I have discussed. Going forward, it's a strong suggestion that everyone should consider making their will. To give peace of mind and a sense of security to the family. Will making is so simple nowadays. You can go online. We have also created an online website, willsurvey.com, where one can go register, provide the details in a systematic manner, and the will be drafted by the back office lawyers and will be posted on your dashboard. It is super fast. You can do it at any point of time. You can at your leisure, from your home, in the night or during your holidays, and at the same time it is very cost effective. You can visit willsurvey.com. again, since all of you are financial advisors, we have created a system for financial advisors, as in they can partner with us for drafting of the will of their clients. And we can provide them the back-end support in order to creating the draft and making the will document for your clients. And you can interact with your clients and provide add-on facility to your clients. This is it from my side. And I'm really thankful to all of you for the patience hearing. And I would be happy to take all the questions that you may have. Over to you, Manak.
Some of them are asking for the last page again.
Last page. Just a second.
Your details, I think.
Just a second. I'll just open.
There is a question also. Vijay Bhardwajji, there is a question from him. Yes, Vijay ji.
Hello.
Haan ji sir, bataiye.
Haan sir, namaskar.
Namaskar ji, namaskar.
Sabse pehle to aapko dhanyawad, itni badhiya tarike se aapne jankari provide ki uske liye. Mere man mein ek sawal hai chota hai. Aapne ek jagah bola jab aap class 1 aur class 2 aur class 3 bata rahe the. आपने फीमेल टेस्टेटर फीमेल इनिशिएट डाइट होता है तो उसमें आपने बताया लीगल है वो फर्स्ट बैंड